defeating European powers and pirates in the far corners of the globe, Calypso's design was a quirky combination of sail and steam.
She has a steam engine, but Calypso can also go under sail power. That means that Calypso can go on a long patrol and just use the wind to get where she needs to go.
This helped the vessel ply the waters that were in vast distant colonies where they may not have access to any resources. What we see here is design features that actually make the vessel more reliable and allow it to carry out its duties.
Endurance and toughness was at the heart of the Calypso, and her strength was reinforced by her strange hull construction.
A hull is actually composite. In fact, it's a steel hull, steel plates over an iron frame, all very modern. But then you've got this weird addition of wood. You can see the timber still sticking out of the water today. Now, why would you bother putting wood over steel?
Steel on its own won't protect the ship from what's called biofouling, which is the buildup of barnacles and algae, which can damage the hull and the propulsion system.
So the solution was to coat the hull with copper.
But you can't put copper plates on a steel hull because you get galvanic corrosion. You'll actually corrode the hull itself because of the reaction from these two metals. The only thing to do is to have your steel hull, put wood over the top of that, and then copper sheets in the same old way over the top again.
In June 1883, she is launched to great fanfare.
He's asleep.
From the Chatham Dockyards in England. Built for strength.
He's been like this about 5 minutes.
The last steam and sail.